what inspires me is the life around me. Whatever I see is interesting to me. Oh, let's see, it has a name. Maybe Blue Day or Green Day. Green Day, I think. I have to think of titles. I like to break up shapes. If I see something, I like to break it into pieces. Oh, it's nice too. Very nice. Yeah, I kind of like it. I'm happy to see it. Painting colors and shapes, going from one thing to another. I forgot the title. Well, it has nice shapes, nice colors, and also I like color harmonies. When you have a key color and then the adjacent colors to it harmonizing, so they harmonize. You know the coffee pot, and artists would sometimes come and sit around and chat and talk, drink coffee or whatever. And one day, this man, he told me that every day had a color, and to be in cosmic harmony, you should heed the colors of the day. Actually, today is white day. Saturday is purple and gold. Sunday is yellow. Monday is pink. Tuesday is blue. Wednesday is green. Thursday, what is Thursday? Thursday is purple. And Friday is white. What did I say about purple and gold? I was lying in the bed, and there was this wonderful light from the sun coming through the window, and it lighted on an armoire where there were the patterns of some wooden sculpture. I started crying. My father and mother came into the door, holding me in their arms, comforting, becoming conscious. In the first memory of my life, I didn't know then that sunlight streaming through windows and quiet afternoons would always be loosened with revelation. The air is charged with ecstatic noise. Night explodes with songs. Well, if anybody wants to know something, I'd be glad to tell you.
Well, I have a question. So what inspired you to pursue art and poetry, like in the future?
Well, I always liked to draw, even as a little child. I had a little book, paper, and colors. And I would like to draw the table and chairs and people sitting. You know, when we were children, we walked all over the city of Frankfurt, and there were wonderful cafes, and the aroma of cake and pie and coffee was lovely. It was a very good time before the Nazis came. So we couldn't go to school anymore after a while. They would not take Jewish students. It was a terrible time. What I remember is you could not get in, you could not get out. I was very grateful to my father and mother, and they both tried very hard. And he would come back and come back, trying to get a visa for my sister and me. I wish he had also gotten visas for him and for my mother. And my brothers were on the children transport. I was 17, my sister was 15 and a half. Of course, America was big. And everything was larger. We learned by walking and by looking. The skyscrapers were so impressive. I had been walking, looking trying to find a job, actually. I didn't know the language, didn't have money. I had a little room that looked out on a brick wall. And when I came home, I laid down on the bed. I was very tired. In fact, I felt this is what dying must be like. But something very strange happened. As I let go of everything, suddenly I felt a stream of warm light going through me. And the light was all over my body. I felt revived. I felt kind of blissful. And I realized that when you come to the bottom, the end of things, suddenly there is this light. I had several angels in my life. I still have. There are angels everywhere. One of the angels in my life, we had a wonderful teacher at the American People's School. Carl Nelson was his name, but he was a wonderful teacher, a wonderful artist, and he was kind of like a signpost. Later he told somebody, I just talked to the cutest girl. I could not understand a word she said. And I think because of him, I got to be a teacher too. Can you show the picture of Carl?
Oh yeah.
And he opens for people the world of art, of painting. And every Saturday we would go downtown in New York to the village, see the shows, the exhibitions going on. And then he would talk about the artists. I was not interested in getting married. I was not interested in doing housework, or cooking, or having children, none of that. Everybody my age, as a young woman, wanted to get married. Why would I not try to understand who I was, or what I was, or what I was wanting to do in my life? My sister says that you were the first flower girl. And then one day I said to her, why don't you go and live with our brothers? And they were sent to Baltimore to live with the family. So my sister went to Baltimore, and I'm going west. She was happy in Baltimore, and she got married and got a husband, everything. And she had nice houses. I always had to scramble for a living space. I didn't mind. I still talk to her every night. I got on the bus. I had $35 in my purse. One night in New Mexico, the bus stopped and a young man sat down next to me. And then he asked me, where are you going? And I said, I don't know. I'm looking for a nice city to live in. And he said, oh, Santa Barbara is a fine place to live in. Okay. And when the bus stopped in Santa Barbara, I got out and I smelled the ocean air. I said, I'm going to stay here. And I always painted on the floor. I didn't ever have a studio. I like always drawing people, faces, bodies. I consult my feelings. What am I feeling at the moment? And sometimes, you know, my paintings are like journals. What happened during the day, or what inspired me during the day, and then figures, people. And don't be discouraged with life, because life is splendid. So whenever you have a job that you don't like, quit. Get a job you like, or get something to do that you really like, because life is too precious to waste it.
Are you crying?
I'm tearing up.
I know what you feel. I know how you feel, how it feels to be young. Fundamentally, we are happy beings. It's just wonderful to be alive, to breathe. God gave free will to every being, to every living being. What you do with it, unfortunately, the Nazis did evil. That's my mother. She was the sweetest woman in the whole wide world. And my mother and another brother and his family all moved, went to Paris. They thought they would escape the Nazis. So my father went over the Alps with a few other men. They climbed over the Alps trying to get into Italy, I think. However, Italy also became, you know, where the Nazis were there, and they were caught, and he was put in a concentration camp. But he worked as a cook. He learned how to cook. Actually, he cooked for us, made potato soup and cabbage salad. Very good. So he worked as a cook, and I think that saved him. My mother, one evening, she was coming home, and a man stopped her and said, "Don't go into the house. The Nazis are there waiting for you." And she said, "Why would they harm me? Nothing's going to happen to me." She went in, and unfortunately, they took her then, put her on a train and to Auschwitz. But one day, I remember, I walked in New York in the street, and suddenly I felt my heart pounding and kind of skipping beats, and I had a feeling that I lost her.
Wow.
Yeah. That we lost her. My poor mother did not survive the war. So God gave free will to everybody, even to the Nazis. They didn't have to be evil. Unfortunately, they were. But I did not stay with that. I wanted to be happy. I never thought of them. My sister, unfortunately, carried them with her. She felt, she remembered the past too vividly. And I keep telling her, if they can make you unhappy, can make you suffer, then they won. People told me that the figures reminded them of the people we lost. And I liked that. I wanted that. I tried to paint that. I don't want to be explicit, so I didn't spell out the words. I just made letters. And that is the Negev, and the Negev is the desert in Israel. Oh, woodblocks are easy. You take a piece of wood and you dig into it with a carving knife. This is musica, I call it. Musicians. Yeah, and he's looking at her. Well, I'm glad that to see that. I've forgotten about it. I like to draw out what I'm going to do. Well, he's kind of dancing. Maybe I just call it freedom or something like that. Stars, let's see. Galaxies. Yeah, the galaxies. Well, these are our people being lined up. Yeah, lined up. Very unhappy people. And this is kind of the trains that brought them. Yeah, I don't dwell on it. But if it comes to me, I sit down and I stay with it until the feeling resolves itself. But I am not avoiding the feeling of suffering. What helps is to honor it. But these are our people, you know, who went through it. What are your feelings? Turn to your feelings and be true to them. Yeah, be true to yourself.
I eat fresh fruit, fruit and veggies. I like to drink green juices.
My sister said I was the first vegetarian. Actually, I'm going to a chiropractor, and his healing method is to be positive, to tell your body good things, healing things. He charges quite a bit.
A dog jumped on me.
I know.
So I broke it in.
I know.
The light is inside of you, inside of everybody. And in the painting, colors, I think God likes colors. So I think the world is full of colors and beauty. I think God is a great artist because every day there is a new design in the sky. Every morning, a new wonderful sunrise, a wonderful sunset, full of colors, full of riches. Yeah. And there are very good people, people who like doing good. And I think all of this is God's work. Yeah. And learn to be happy. It's a gift. It's a gift to be. How does that sound go?
It's a gift to be simple. It's a...
Yeah.
It's a gift to be simple. It's a gift to be...
Turning me from outright. Wonderful. Beautiful. Thank you.